I was one of the very first care package recipients during post-World War II. We were refugees from, which is now Russia. My father was in Russian prison camp. He did not get out till 1949. And my mother had the three of us. I was the oldest. And she did not care too much about the Americans because during the last air raid in Germany by the Americans, her parents got killed. And having just grown up and not having had any food, we were just emaciated, I mean, really thin. The very first care package which I received, it was a little box. Later on, we got larger ones, but this was just for the children in school. And in the care package was white paper, really white paper, and a pencil and an eraser, Colgate toothpaste and a toothbrush. The boys had a little matchbox car and the girls got a little doll. When I came home to my mother and showed her this, I said, the Americans did this. It just left such an imprint. How Americans can do this to the enemy. You know, I mean, I just said, wow. When I grow up, I go to America. It changed a little girl's mind. And then subsequently to that, we received packages from a wonderful family in Buffalo, New York. And in it were always used clothing and shoes. And I thought I was the best dressed person in the whole wide world. Of course, time went on, schooling, university. I finished university. I had a job lined up. I had a boyfriend. But this urge to go because of care, this urge to go to America was stronger than any bond I had there. And I came to America, I had $100 in my pocket. My English was extremely limited. And I said, here I am, and I'm going to make it no matter what. I am so grateful to care for that wonderful package, which I'll never forget as long as I live.